Hey, how are you? So throughout the 1800s, the U.S. government forced most Native Americans off their land and on the reservations. However, a man by the name of Richard Pratt wanted to help these Indians assimilate into mainstream American society, so set up a school in Pennsylvania called the Carlisle Indian School, whose mission was to do just that. And what better way to make these Indians quote-unquote civilized than teaching them how to play the most barbaric sport in America, football. But what nobody could have predicted is that the Carlisle Indian football team would go on to become one of the most innovative teams in football history. Now, you can't have an innovative football team without an innovative coach. And for 13 seasons, Carlisle's coach was a guy by the name of Pop Warner. Ever heard of him? Just the most influential coach of all time, whose name is now synonymous with youth football. Not a big deal. While coaching at Carlisle, he helped revolutionize the game, inventing the three-point stance, body blocking technique, and precursors for what would become the spread and shotgun formations. Oh, and ever heard of the hidden ball trick? Where upon receiving the kickoff, the offense huddles together, slips the ball under someone's jersey, then they all break out running towards the end zone while the defense poops their pants out of sheer confusion? Well, you can thank Pop Warner and the Carlisle Indians for that. They first used it successfully against Harvard in 1903, and oh man, those pretentious Harvard pricks were none too happy knowing a bunch of scrawny Indians made them look like idiots. How do you like them apples? What most solidifies Carlisle's impact on football, though, is the fact that they were the first team to ever embrace the forward pass. Forward passes were prohibited up until 1905, when they were legalized in an attempt to make the sport safer, as at that time, football was killing around 18 players a year. Not ideal. But just because teams could, didn't mean QB started slinging it all over the place. Forward passes were seen as for sissies, and a gamble, as back then, an incomplete pass resulted in a 15-yard penalty. However, Pop Warner saw it as the perfect weapon that his smaller yet faster Native American players could use to beat much heavier opponents. And that's exactly what they did. In their 1907 season, Carlisle passed the ball 50% of the time, dominated teams like Penn and Harvard, and only lost a single game. They would continue to be a national powerhouse for much of the next decade, bundling more prominent schools like Army, when future President Dwight D. Eisenhower was on the team, and birthing legends like Jim Thorpe, Carlisle's star player, who would go on to become the first Native American to win a gold medal in the Olympics. Sadly, Carlisle School was closed down and turned into a hospital at the start of World War I, and for some reason, Notre Dame gets most of the credit for pioneering the forward pass, after their QB threw for 243 yards in a single game during their 1913 season. Hopefully now, though, you'll at least think of these American legends the next time you unleash a tight spiral in your backyard. In Hollywood, for the love of God, chill with the sequels and reboots and turn this team into a fucking movie already. It's pretty much Remember the Titans on steroids.